wanna be lost, I wanna be lost in you. Show your beauty, show your strength in this holy place. Let it be like gravity that I can't escape till my life has been transformed. Jesus, all powers have to bow. Oh, and at the name of Jesus, darkness has to go. Oh, and in the name of Jesus, I have the victory. For Jesus has given me the keys. And at the name of Jesus, all powers have to bow. Oh, and at the name of Jesus, darkness has to go. Oh, and in the name of Jesus, I have the victory.
So I speak your name. always speak your name, a powerful name. So always speak your name.
No sweeter name than the name of Jesus. No sweeter name have I ever known. No sweeter name than the name of Jesus. No sweeter name than the name of Jesus. No sweeter name have I ever known. No sweeter name than the name of Jesus. You are the life to my heart and my soul. You are the light to the darkness around me. You are the hope to the hopeless and broken. You are
no sweeter name than the name of Jesus. No sweeter name have I ever known. No sweeter name than the name of Jesus. No sweeter name than the name of Jesus. No sweeter name have I ever known. No sweeter name than the name of Jesus. You are the life to my heart and my soul. You are the light to the darkness around me. You are the hope to the hopeless and broken. You are the only truth and the way. You are the life to my heart and my soul. You are the light to the darkness around me. You are the hope to the hopeless and broken. You are the only truth.
Truth and way. words back up there one more time. Put those words back up there one more time. There they are. Okay. I'm going to continue tonight with Ephesians 6:10. But it's really an expression of Paul's heart. And at this point, Paul was in prison. And I can hear him singing this song. He's not a stranger to prison. He and Silas were in prison together. And when I started this study in Ephesians, talked about how he started to write the book as if he was writing a letter to some people, to the assemblies or to the believers. Before he came across this whole thought about the armor of God. But Paul's in prison. Probably a cold, damp, dark, dirty place. And we read before that Paul and Silas sang. Remember when they were in prison together and they sang and what happened at that point? So this, I'm sure that something so close to this must have been flowing in Paul's heart to keep him going. And that revelation of, you know, he probably looked up from his pen and paper and began to stare at the guard, and God began to talk to him about that whole dress of the guard, of the soldier. And as he began to think about that, God revealed to him the parallels. But Paul was not a stranger to the prison. And the fact is, he wrote 4 books during his stays in prison. Philippians, Philemon, Colossians, and Ephesians were all written while he was incarcerated.